Since there are so many of us, they can't break those promises anymore. This is the day that we get together for the reaffirmation of love and knowing that it's such a wonderful world. I see trees of green, red roses too. I see them bloom for me and you, and I think to myself, what a wonderful world. I see skies of blue, clouds of white, bright blessed days, dark sacred nights, and I think to myself, what a wonderful world. The colors of the rainbow, so pretty in the sky, are also in the faces of people going by. I see friends shaking hands, saying, how do you do? They really say, I love you. I hear babies cry, I watch them grow. They learn much more than I'll ever know. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. Yeah, I think to myself, what a wonderful world.
I have known Kevin since childhood and watched him as he grew to be a handsome young attorney that we see before us today. So, when Dr. Susan Karimi asked me to perform this ceremony, I did not hesitate and gladly accepted. Today, I have the honor to be trusted by Kevin and Emily to perform this marriage ceremony in accordance with our tradition of Persian culture. گفتی که بیا که باغ خندید و بهار شمع است و شراب و شاهدون چون گل نار اونجا که تو نیستی از اینها چه سود اونجا که تو هستی What does it harm the chicken? Next from Khayyam, it is no West. You have filled my life with joy, like sacks of sugar. Preserved me like a petaled rose in sugar. And now today I'm seized by peals of laughter. What joyous sounds you sprinkle on my mouth. جانم ز طرب چون شکرم باشته ای چون برگ گل اندر شکرم کار داشته ای امروز مرا خنده فرا میگیرد تا در دهنم چه خنده ها There are flowers and wine and love of my dreams The grand ruler of this world envy me No need for candles to light up the gathering for Perfection of my lover's face is all illuminating. گل در برا می در کف و معشوق به کام است سلطان جهانم به چنین روز غلام است گوشم میاری در این جمع که امشب در مجلس ما ماه رخ دوست تمام است Today, this marriage assembly has been in accordance with Iranian customs and traditions so that I, Homayun Shibnyan, can unite Emily Grace Callas and beloved, the beloved daughter of Mrs. Carol Lisa Callas and Mr. Orlando Bridges, who unfortunately passed away this recent week. And Kevin Karimi, son of Dr. Susan Karimi and Dr. Kambis Karimi, in the presence of you, dearest guests, at this auspicious and fortunate time, and on behalf of all honorable guests present in this assembly, I ask that this forthcoming union be blessed with stability, love, happiness, success, abundance, honor, and prosperity.
Now, you mentioned children.
With much of happiness and great joy, I ask you, Kevin, do you grant me the permission and the power to marry you permanently and eternally to Emily Grace Callas?
Yes, I do.
Now, with much happiness and great joy, I ask you, Emily Grace Callas, do you grant me the permission and the power to marry you permanently and eternally to Kevin Karimi?
She's too excited. She's not paying attention. She's too taken by Kevin.
Now, with much happiness and great joy, I ask you, Emily Grace Callas, do you grant me the permission and the power to marry you permanently and eternally to Kevin Karimi?
Oh, I'm sorry, I was showing her this picture. I don't think she was paying attention.
I have to do it again.
Go ahead, ask her again. Sorry.
Now, with much happiness and great joy, I ask you, Emily Grace Callas, do you grant me the permission and the power to marry you permanently and eternally?
Which is even
Kevin Karimi.
I do. Yeah!
Now, on this ninth day of September 2016, Common Era, corresponding to 19th of Shakri Barma, 1395 in solar calendar, and based upon the power you have entrusted to you, I marry you to each other in accordance to tradition of Iranian culture, and pronounce you husband and wife. This ring that you placed on signify your eternal commitment to one another.
That's longer than permanent.
May you always be guided by love, peace, and wisdom in your shared life. Never forget that the happiness comes from commitment, love, forgiveness, loyalty, and mutual respect.
And saying yes to your
now,
wife all the time.
Now, share a kiss and begin your beautiful life together. Thank you.
I met Emily when I was working in Court 18 and immediately adored her. She's warm and funny and bright and awesome. So, of course, I immediately felt the kinship because I am also awesome. I knew I could relate to her. So adored her from the beginning. Now, Kevin was a different story. I am definitely telling it.
Great.
Yeah, I know you're excited about that. Right, so I'm sitting in Court 18 and Kevin is going after a DUI felony conviction. But unfortunately, I felt that he only proved a misdemeanor.
Mm-hmm.
So it was at that point, my first real interaction with him, that I was absolutely convinced that he was attempting to set me on fire with his mind. There was no question at all. So two important things I learned immediately at that point. And that was first is that Kevin has no poker face. So for those of you who play cards with him, I'm guessing he just hands you his wallet. Maybe you go through his pockets for loose change because he has no poker face. All right. The other thing I learned about him was that he is an extremely passionate man, a man of great conviction. And then as I got to know him, I found him to be a man of incredible intelligence and great honor. So I can only say that your parents should be so incredibly proud of you for the man, the human being that you are. We're not here to witness the beginning of their relationship. In fact, we're here to acknowledge and rejoice in the love that they already have, that already exists between them. And their commitment speaks of shared experiences, the good and the bad, and everything in between, their dreams, and the significant role that they play in each other's lives and have played and will play. Marriage is an act of deep trust and faith in the strength of your love. You cannot base it on the hope that someday the other person will be different or will be better or will do something other than what they already do. In fact, you must trust in who they are now, accept them at this very moment for who they are now, and have faith in what you don't know. So, Kevin, I ask you, are you prepared to go forward today, trusting what you know of Emily, having faith in what you do not, committing yourself during good times and bad for the rest of your natural life?
Yes.
Okay. And Emily, are you prepared to go forward today, trusting what you know of Kevin, having faith in what you do not, committing yourself during good times and bad, and committing yourself to him for the rest of your natural life?
Yes.
Was there a doubt there about what she was going to say?
Yes, I am.
All right. And a youth said, speak to us in friendship. Your friend is your needs answered. He is your field which you sow with love and reap with thanksgiving. And he is your board and your fireside. For you come to him with your hunger and you seek him for peace. When your friend speaks his mind, you fear not the nay in your own mind, nor do you withhold the eye. And when he is silent, your heart ceases not to listen to his heart. For without words, in friendship, all thoughts, all desires, all expectations are born and shared with joy that is unacclaimed. There are times, and there will be times, over the years, when you will take on different roles with each other. You will be husband and wife, you will be lover, you will be mother and father, you will be child. There will be times when you are running around chasing after Kennedy where you swear you're more like roommates than you are husband and wife, all right? That is the nature of a long-term relationship. It is fluid. It contracts, it expands, it ebbs, it flows. Now is the time where we're going to have Kevin and Emily exchange rings to symbolize their commitment. The rings are significant for two reasons. First, they're made from precious metal, and they represent the wealth of love and affection between Kevin and Emily. Second, these rings have no beginning and no end. So too will their love have no beginning and no end. I give you this ring as a symbol of our love.
I give you this ring as a symbol of our love.
For today and tomorrow.
For today and tomorrow.
And for all the days to come.
And for all the days to come.
Wear it as a sign of what we have promised today.
Wear it as a sign of what we have promised today.
And know that my love is present.
And know that my love is present.
Even when I am not.
Even when I am not.
Emily, please take Kevin's hand. I give you this ring as a symbol of our love.
I give you this ring as a symbol of our love.
For today and tomorrow.
For today and tomorrow.
And for all the days to come.
And for all the days to come.
Wear it as a sign of what we have promised today.
Wear it as a sign as what for what we have promised today.
And know that my love is present.
And know that my love is present.
Even when I am not.
Even when I am not.
Now you will feel no rain, for each of you will be the shelter for the other. Now you will feel no cold, for each of you will be the warmth to the other. Now there will be no loneliness, for each of you will be the companion to the other. Now you are two persons, but there is only one life before you. May beauty surround you both in journey ahead and through all the years. May happiness be your companion, and your days together be good and long upon the earth. Treat yourselves and each other with respect, and remind yourselves often of what brought you together. Give the highest priority to the tenderness, the gentleness, and kindness that your connection deserves. When frustration, difficulties, and fear assail your relationship, as they threaten all relationships at one time or another, remember to focus on what is right between you, not only the part that seems wrong. In this way, you can ride out the storms when clouds hide the face of the sun, remembering that even if you lose sight of it for a moment, the sun is still there. Mm-hmm. So Kevin and Emily, you've taken your vows and you've exchanged your rings. Now, by the power vested in me by the state of Indiana, I hereby pronounce you husband and wife. You may kiss the
character that served the princess. She did everything for the princess growing up. Well, as most of you would assume, two little girls would be fighting over who would be the princess character, correct? Oh no, not Emily. You see, she insisted that I always be Miss Millay, which of course I was okay with. As a child, I was like, score, I get to be the princess again. I remember specifically telling her, Emmy, I think it's your turn to be Miss Millay. She's like, no, I want to be this other nameless character that just did everything for the princess. And as I'm coming to an adult, I realize the deeper meaning in this. You see, Emily's selfless and genuine character has reigned true from a very early age. She has the biggest heart of anyone I know, truly.
Yes.
29th birthday party that you so kindly had me involved in. She gave everybody an individual thank you note, thanking them, for coming to her own birthday party and telling them just how kind they were and how much they meant to her. And I just think that's so special. It's just, it really showcases her character. Through, you know, high school, college, we kind of went separate ways. But when we did reconnect, it was always, we kind of picked up from where we left off. And it was always just a special bond. It's special to find somebody who knows you, who knows everything about you, but doesn't judge you. Because we've been through some stuff together, and just with life in general. And she's been there for me through thick and thin. And I just want to thank you so much for that. I can't even put it into words. I always said that Emily deserves a man in her life. I made cards, but I'm not even reading them. It's fine. Emily deserves a man in her life who will absolutely cherish her, who will take care of her like she takes care of everyone in her life, who is strong and smart and funny and a little bit quirky, of course, to compliment her quirkiness, because, yeah, she's a little strange. But Kevin, you have far exceeded any expectation I ever had for Emily. You, Kevin, are so genuine and caring and sweet, and you care so deeply about Emily. Not only about Emily, but about all of her. You care so much about her friends and crazy family, and you are there for her through thick and thin. And I just want to say what an honor it has been to meet you, and I love you. And I love the two of you together. You complement each other in a beautiful way that is so rare to find these things. Now, of course, there will be, you know, scuffs in a relationship. In any relationship, even no matter how perfect it is, there'll be hard times. Things that will test a relationship. Baby Kennedy. It isn't easy. It isn't always rainbows, butterflies. Life, take it from Scott and I, who didn't necessarily do things in the right order. It could be chaotic, unpredictable. I once heard a quote that said, parenthood is the only time that you can experience heaven and hell at the same time. But luckily, just lower your standards for cleanliness, overall peace, order, and you'll be fine. I'm kidding, kind of. Yeah. Just laugh at the idiosyncrasy that life will throw you. You know, just remember that all of these things that we're experiencing, they'll be over before we know it. So just try to cherish every moment, you know, those sleepless nights, poopy diapers, and the terrible twos, Lord help me. Because you will miss it one day. And really, Kevin, as much as baby Kennedy is going to be wrapped around the little pinky finger of yours, try to keep your two relationship in the forefront, because baby Kennedy will appreciate it later in life. But, you know, I have no doubt in my mind that you two will do that. You've already shown me that you two have a deep connection, you two have open communication. Each of you make the other person want to be a better person. I've seen that, witnessed it, I can just feel it. The two of you have such a special bond together. And you each love each other with your whole heart, which is just so special. And what more do we want in a life partner, honestly? So my final thoughts, as much as I can ramble on all night, is just I am so excited for you guys. I wish you nothing but a lifetime of love, happiness, and I'm so excited for all the fun times ahead. And let's give a warm and loving toast to the new and happy couple, Emily and Kevin Karimi.
I'm excited to see where things are gonna go to. I'm excited for baby Kennedy. I'm excited to see you grow. You're such a comforting and loving person that I know that your baby's gonna be just fine. If you can hang on a Scoop for 9 to 10 years, and he's like a senile geriatric, even though he's a dog, Emily takes care of this dog like no other. And so with that being said, I'm just really happy to be here and be able to enjoy this experience with all of you and be a part of your family. So I always considered Emily my sister, and now I'm glad to say that I have a brother as well.
Hello, everyone. Thank you for joining us for our celebration of our lovely children, Kevin and Emily. We're here to celebrate the reunion of love of our wonderful children. And I thank you, first, the family members and the friends for attending this wonderful celebration of love. Emily is a wonderful girl. She's beautiful inside and out. I really mean it, inside and out. We're so blessed to have such a wonderful, beautiful woman joining us as our daughter. Call it daughter-in-law, but she's actually a daughter. We were blessed 3 years ago with a wonderful daughter-in-law named Nina, and now we're more lucky to have two of them now. And we're very happy for our sons to be so happy.
Yes. Waiting for a third one for Cameron.
Also very, very blessed with a newer family member named Kennedy Grace. So today when I was thinking about the wedding, I said, thank God everything is going smoothly. I have to start thinking about the baby shower. And again, thank you so much for everyone to be here. And it's an honor to have you all in this celebration of love of our children. Thank you very much.
I don't have much more to say, except I want to share some experience that I had with Kevin when he was young. Don't worry, it's not bad.
Don't say the bad part.
Kevin was about 6 or 7 years old. I used to give him talk to my colleagues, and then on the way going home, I always took some steak or lobster. Oh, you don't remember? Okay. So one time, there was a Morton Steakhouse. I took a steak for Kevin and Keon, and then when I walked out, there was a homeless guy sitting next to Morton Steakhouse. And he said he was hungry, so I gave him the food, and I went home without any food. When I got home, I said, I was afraid that he's gonna be so upset, he's only 7 years old. I said, Kevin, there was somebody who was homeless, I gave it to him. He said, Dad, that was wonderful, I'm glad you did that. I love you, Kevin. You have such a large heart, just like Keon and Cameron. I'm so proud of you. Well, genius, you are. And I tried to teach you math, I gave up at the 7th grade. So, Emily, we love you to come to this family. You're so beautiful, And you really are inside out. I don't know what that means, but you are. And we're looking forward to have a wonderful family together. That's all I have to say. And thank you, everybody, for coming.
So I'm going to make it quick for you guys. I just want to talk a little bit about Kevin and Emily, my new sister. Kevin was always growing up with me. Keon was about 8 years ahead of me, Kevin 4. I lived with Kevin for about off and on for 4 years in three different houses, the 910 Eagle Creek apartment, Eagle Creek house. Kevin used to whoop my behind when I was growing up, made me a man. Kevin taught me what it is to be a roommate and clean up after myself, because you know, my mom used to take care of everything growing up for me as far as mess. So Kevin, I really cherish those days. I remember the beef stroganoff he used to make for me. That was fire. I miss him. I really had a lot of good times. I saw Kevin go through law school. He literally was molding on a couch for 3 years, reading big, giant books as I was having the time of my life. Emily, I've met you a handful of times. We've known each other for a better portion of a year. Just like everyone has said about you, you're beautiful in and out. I'm really happy to have you as my sister. From the day we were driving around in California, blasting Future in my car, I knew that we were all gonna have a good time. So anyway, thanks again, everybody. I love both of you very much.
I enjoyed 4 years of soul attention 1980 to 1984. Those were the four best years of my life. And on December 7th, 1984, Kevin came into the world. Ever since he was born, Kevin was a persuader. He could persuade me to let him play with my friends, to give him my last piece of kebab, even if I really wanted it. Kevin was so persuasive. He basically got his way, and he always made me think that it was like my choice. You know, growing up, we were only 4 years apart, and I wanted to be with my friends, and I wanted to exclude Kevin, but fortunately, Kevin did not allow himself to be excluded. And so we played together, we hung out together, and we really didn't grow close until we both moved away and were getting later in our lives professionally. And now I'm just so proud of you with everything that you've accomplished. Your persuasion has led to the highest level of persuasion. Who knew you'd be putting the bad guys away? We're so proud of you, and it took no persuasion to fall in love with Emily when we met you, because you brought someone so beautiful and genuine into our family and into our lives. We're so blessed to see your union together, and we're really excited to join our families, to see it grow. I'm getting a lot of crap for not being the first one to have a baby, but we won't be far behind. Love you guys, congratulations.
Kevin is a very lucky man. I know he knows that. For those of you who don't know me, my name is Brandon Skates. I am one of Kevin's friends. We met in law school. I am also the president and founder of the Kevin and Emily Fan Club. We have a very extensive application process for those of you who are interested in joining. 2016 has not been an easy year, really, for anyone, but I know that it's been particularly difficult for these two. Emily lost her father, and Kevin lost a dear friend as well during this calendar year. And I know that they're both here with us tonight, but it was also during those events that I learned so much about them as a couple. During Emily's struggle, Kevin was amazing. He was her voice when she couldn't speak. He was her balance when she couldn't walk. and he was the person on which she relied upon. He coordinated calls and text messages for her, and he made sure that she was surrounded by her friends. During that period of time is when I saw my friend transform into a truly different person, because she needed him too. I knew then that was it. I knew that my friend had found his forever person, and there's nothing like that feeling, like knowing that one of your good friends has just found a true happiness. I suppose that the writing was on the wall for some time. I remember one of the early cues was a Facebook picture that Emily put up of the two of them. Now, those of you who have seen this picture, you know exactly the one I'm talking about. Kevin was shirtless, and they were hugging each other, and they were just cheesing. And I remember, like, Kevin, if you know Kevin, you know that is completely out of his character. Not the hairy chest part, that is in his character. But he is a bizarrely private person. Like, for instance, if I am in his office on my iPhone, he still asks me if I'm recording him. For absolutely no reason. And anyways, after that picture, there were so many questions being asked at work the next day. Most of them were about the babe in Kevin's picture, but also people wanted to know about their relationship status. So, being one of Kevin's good friends, I took it upon myself to protect his privacy. I went to Kevin and I asked him what was going on with the photo. And he told me that he wanted Emily to take the photo down, but he didn't want to hurt her feelings. So I formulated this great plan in which when Emily came to his office at the end of the day, I would tease her about the photo, and which would encourage her to move it. That way, Kevin could stay in her good graces, but the photo would also be taken down. It sounded like a perfect win-win situation. However, the first part of the plan went smoothly. When she arrived at the office, I brought up the photo when I started teasing her a little bit about it, and it seemed as if she were about to recommend taking the photo down. Then, out of nowhere, Kevin switched sides and sided with Emily. And they laughed, and she gave him a big kiss, and I sat there betrayed and confused. When Emily left, I asked Kevin why he didn't stick to the plan. And honest to God, he said he had to make a choice between his pride and his girl, and he was choosing Emily. I hope Kevin always remembers that. I hope that he always remembers the time that he betrayed one of his best friends for a girl that he just met. No, that's not true. I hope you always remember choosing her. Emily, I am a huge, huge fan of yours. I frequently remind Kevin how much you love him, and it's obvious to anyone who's around you who sees your face when you talk about him. So now, Kevin, I will remind you of why you must continue to love her. Emily is a treasure because she is kind, she is sweet, and she is sincere. She laughs at most of your jokes, and a lot of them aren't even funny.
Most of them are.
And think of how much you trust her. There will be no greater gift in your life that you will receive than her company and support. And Emily, Kevin will be a pleasure for you too. He's always the life of the party. Whether he's kicking a fire hydrant outside the living room lounge or making funny faces at little girls during summer baseball games, he's the star of the show. He is a sensitive and genuine person. He's loyal and he loves you. I asked my grandparents, who are celebrating their 65th year of marriage, for some advice, because I don't have any to give you on that subject. My grandfather said to make sure that they love each other. We've covered that the both of you do. He said the other thing that he would do is he would remind you that a marriage, it's a journey. The wedding is just the destination. While this night has been beautiful, it is nothing compared to what the rest of your lives will be together. So may your love always endure into the Karimis.
Kevin is a great guy, and I'm so honored to be here today. And just like a lot of people have mentioned here who've spoken tonight, Kevin has really transformed in the past. Began when he was in law school, but this past year I've seen him take off, and I'm just so impressed and just so happy to see how happy Kevin is. And Emily, I know that's because of you. And it makes me so happy to see how happy the two of you make each other. So I guess everybody's happy. And yeah, Kevin, best of times, worst of times, we've been friends, right? There's been times, could elaborate a little bit on that, but needless to say, without getting into much detail, I think Kevin saved my life more than a handful of times, and I'd hope I'd at least have, be able to say I might have saved his. Got him out of a tricky situation once or twice myself. And Kevin, I look at you as my brother, and I would do anything in your best interest within the limits of the ethical rules.
Right.
And I'm proud to be able to speak on your behalf today and wish nothing but the best to you and Emily. Thank you.
I've known Kevin for more than half my life. I've known Emily for even longer, since Cambridge days. And I will say that I don't know anyone in this world like either one of you. You truly are very unique people. And what's so special about both of you is that you're Kevin and Emily, no matter what situation, no matter where you're at, you don't change. You're one of the few people I know that actually keeps it real wherever and whenever. And you both know that I'm always going to be there for you. And I love you guys.
Now, here's the thing. I've already given all my advice. I've already said all my sage words. Now, I'm going to tell a story. And this is the story that Kevin begged me not to tell, but I'm gonna do anyway. Why? Because I can. Okay? And as a judge, that's just what we do. All right, so here is the real deal about how they really met and started dating, and it's all because of me. Yes, thank you very much. Okay? So, in court 18, I'd been sitting for a while. The judge had been ill, and so I sort of assumed the court for a little bit on an on and off basis. And I came to know Emily, of course, immediately adored her. Came to know Kevin, yeah. So we've already heard that story, right? Of course, courts, they talk, okay? If you think for a moment that it's not like high school in a court, you are so mistaken. They are talking all the time about prosecutors, about public defenders, about the defendants, about this, about that. There's gossip all the time. It is all over the place, all right? So as a judge, you are gonna hear this. You're gonna hear the gossip. And me, being an old Italian woman, I am naturally going to step in and try to match make. Why? It's in my DNA. I cannot help it. It's a compulsion, among other things. But that's probably the nicest one that I have. So in any event, Emily and I start talking, and she shares with me that she's been emailing back and forth with Kevin. Nothing much has really come of it. They've just been sort of talking back and forth. Then I hear from one of the clerks, again remembering this is high school, right, just in a court setting. I hear from one of the clerks that, in fact, that Kevin may have a super-duper crush on Emily, but he's not really moving forward on him. So, I take the opportunity. We're at a bar across the street after hours, and everyone's having a drink, and I grab him outside, and I say, hey, you know that clerk that you're emailing with? And he stops, and he pauses, and he pretends like he doesn't know who I'm talking about. Of course, he's a miserable liar. Again, no poker face. So, do you mean Emily? Yes, of course I mean Emily. Yeah. Anyway, she's really interested in you. You should ask her out. Huh. Okay. And he goes on his way. So nothing happens, nothing happens, nothing happens. And finally, I'm in court one day, and Emily slips me a note. It's a little handwritten note. And now, bear in mind, we're about to go into a bench trial, okay? So Kevin is about to lay the smack down on a DUI defendant who's just guilty as ever loving sin, all right? So Kevin is just gonna ream him up one side, down the other, and the guy frankly deserves it. Not that I have an opinion on it, because I'm just the judge. So anyway, Emily hands me this note, and it says, "Thank you so much for, you know, playing the matchmaker between us. I'm trying not to freak Kevin out too much by emailing him. He's just so cute," or words to that effect. It was just the most adorable, fabulous thing I've ever seen. So me being me, I immediately call Karimi in, and I'm like, "Karimi, you're in the chambers right now." He's like, "Oh, son of a, okay, all right." So he comes trundling on back because, again, we've already had a fabulous interaction with one another. And he comes in, and I hand him the note. And I'm like, "All right, are you familiar with parole evidence?" He's like, "Well, yes, I am familiar with parole evidence." And for those of you who are not lawyers, parole evidence is oral testimony that supports a document, okay? So the document may not say what you think it says until you hear from someone who's talking about it, right? So I'm like, "All right, I'm not going to offer you parole evidence because clearly nothing I've said in the past has had any impact on you. Here's the deal. Here's the note. Emily really likes you. You need to ask her out. What the hell? Get off your horse and do something about it." At which point he takes the note and he looks at me. Seriously, I had to make oral argument to this guy to get her to ask her out. So he looks at the note and he looks at me and he's like, "Huh." He gets this kind of look on his face. I've never seen this look on his face before because, well, frankly, he's been something of a jackass to me. He's been wanting to have my head set on fire. So he wanders away, and I'm like, "Okay, well, I hope that had an effect. Hell, I don't know, you know." So we go out, I take the bench, and wouldn't you know it, we end up settling right there and then, before the trial ever takes place, with Kevin saying something along the lines of, I'm afraid they don't even know what BS you made up. You were so happy it was insane. He says something like, "Well, after having heard the defendant testify, I feel very strongly that perhaps he should be given a second chance and, I don't know, only go to prison for a year instead of three." Something like that. Believe me, he doesn't ever give away the farm, ever. But it was nothing short of a miracle that kind of settlement actually happened. I was so impressed that I said to the defendant, "You understand, of course, what a gift Mr. Karimi is giving you, right? Because this would never happen otherwise." And the defendant, "Well, thank you, Mr. Prosecutor, I really appreciate it." Yeah, so anyway, long story short, and I realize it wasn't a very long story, but the attorney likes to hear myself talk. I am solely responsible for fixing the two of them up, and I take complete credit. And as a matter of fact, it took oral argument and documentary evidence submitted to him in order to convince him to do it. So with that said, I have no advice for you other than what I've given. And tell you both, I love you very, very much. So there you go.
It is really an honor to be here surrounded by all of my friends and family and all of the people that, quite frankly, get me through the day, get me through the years. I can't say enough about how special of a person Kevin is. He is a complete, you know, complete partner to me, complete support, outstanding individual. But what's been truly amazing in meeting him and discovering our love together is truly completing our family, completing our friends, finding our pairs. It's been a crazy 6 degrees because he knows people, I know people, his little brother knows my cousin, and we grew up together. And so I think that's really, really special. And I can't thank you guys enough for coming tonight. I feel honored again to have such a beautiful wedding and have such beautiful just love here surrounded. Growing up as an only child, I often struggle with feeling alone, but ever since I met Kevin and ever since all of this has been happening, I don't feel that way anymore at all. I have a whole new other side of my family, and I feel closer with all of my friends and family, and I just feel very honored that you guys can see me tonight in the happiest I've ever been. So thank you guys for being here.
I've gone through a lot of phases in my life. A lot of you have known me through a lot of these different phases. I feel like I am who I will be, but who knows? I never thought that I would get the parents that I have. I never felt like I deserve such beautiful, wonderful parents. I want to start off by thanking them for everything. They're just amazing. I never thought I'd have that. And I always wanted it, and I never knew I had it. I never thought that I'd get the job that I have. I love it. I've always wanted it. And I have it. And I got it. And I want to thank all my colleagues that are here, who I work with, other lawyers in the room. It's something that I never thought I could have. And I didn't. And I never thought that I could have someone so beautiful, so wonderful, so kind, so perfect for me. I just never thought, you know. I just never thought it would happen to me, and it did. It's you. It's all you. It's just you, and I love you, and I'm so happy, and I'm so glad to share this with all the people that I love, and all the people that you love, and all the people that love us are here to watch this. I'm just so happy that I have you, and it's official now, so it's going to be a lot of paperwork if you want out. And I can't even begin to fathom the adventure that we're going to go on with Kennedy. It's just not, I mean, I'm just so worried about 10 fingers, 10 toes. I can't think of anything else. I don't know what's going to happen. I feel so underqualified for this, and I need all of your guys' help.
When he was 4 years old, we called him Judge. Hey, Judge.
I'm sorry.
Hey, Judge.
The weird nickname I had. That totally threw everything off.
What are we talking about?
Emily. Yeah, and the last thing I'll say is, yesterday I had the Persian ceremony. A lot of you were present at. Thank you for being here as well. Thank you all for being here tonight. When I was getting ready for the Persian ceremony, putting on my tux, I realized I was alone. And I wasn't alone because I don't have friends. I mean, look at this head table. People that know me, people that love me, we have deep bonds, and I know you love me, and I know that you'd be there for me, but quite frankly, I didn't really plan ahead, I didn't think about that, so I didn't kind of ask anyone to be there, but I was alone, and I wasn't upset about it, because I didn't feel alone, I wasn't bothered, and I was getting ready for you. I didn't need anyone there, because it was for you. Whether people were there or not, it was all for you. And even today, getting ready, you know, we're at the hotel, my family's around, and I love my family, I love my friends, but it's for you. It's all for you. I love you.
Lovers fall in love. got mad and closed the door. But you said, child, just once more. I chose you for the one. Now we're having so much fun. You treated me so kind. I'm about to lose my mind. You made me so very happy. I'm so glad you came into my life. The others were untrue, but when it came to loving you, cause you came and you took control. You touched my very soul. You always showed me that loving you is where it's at. You made me so very happy. I'm so glad you came into my
some noise for the two of them.
Ey cunan, قدم تو چشام بیا و مهمونم شو. گرمی خونم شو ببین پریشون دلم. بیا آرومم کن ای جونم. میخوام عطر تنت بپیچه تو خونم. تو که نیستی یه سرگردون دیوونم. ای جونم بیا که داغونم. ای جونم عمرم نفسم عشقم. توی همه کسم. آیی که چه خوشحالم تو رو دارم. ای جونم ای جونم دلیل بودنم عشقم. مثل خون تو تنم. آیی که چه خوشحالم تو رو دارم. ای جونم.
Make some noise for the mother and the son.
عروسیشون مبارک.